Stairway to Heaven Arena never gets old. I love being here in Purgatory. And if you love Full Metal Mayhem, you might just want to spend the rest of your life here in Purgatory.
I'd rather take the elevator to hell than spend another minute here. I bet my left nut on their last home game and literally lost half the family jewels in the transaction.
The teams are juiced up and ready for blood as they take the field for MFL action. The Hexxon Oilers take on the Full Metal Mayhem. Welcome to MFL Game Day. Grim Blitzrow here. Let's listen in on the sidelines and hear what the team's captains have to say. Grim Blitzrow with you along with my partner, former player Brickhead Mulligan.
Hi.
And his life partner, the mini mutant head that lives on the shoulder of Bricks Jr.
Hey, you just threw up on my shoulder.
I don't often drink beer, but when I do, I get totally shit-faced. I am the world's most intoxicated man.
Say that again. And it's first and ten. I hope you covered your ears, Briggs, because that was a sonic blast dirty.
First down! I've seen this guy drop a lot of balls in the past, but I heard the quarterback threaten to throw him a real bomb if he dropped one again. You know, good communication is important.
And they'll keep the drive alive as he rifles it in there and picks up 7 yards. Second and three. And the defense puts one over on the quarterback with a sticky ball dirty trick. The only thing the QB can do now is run for his life.
Or die.
Third down and eight. Well, that play didn't work. He'll have to rethink that. Time to see if this is an elite kicker.
Can he kick through a cement wall?
And probably not, Bricks.
Then he's not elite. He kicked that ball so hard, his knee's bound to have permanent damage.
For a kick like that, they'll just buy him a new one.
I don't even have it.
The teams are lined up for the kickoff. He sets up for the return. Let's see if he can break one wide open. And it's first and ten.
I ate a piece of licorice once and got a shot like that.
It wasn't licorice, you idiot. It was the frayed cords of the leaf blower.
Well, it was a red cord and it looked like licorice. The point is... I forgot my point.
Second down and nine. Roid Rage ignites that deep down violent rage and makes you unstoppable.
I'll take a Roid Rage with a pocket chaser. Make it snap you easy.
And he's off to the races. He's at the 20. The 10. Touchdown! I never looked that good dancing, and I have skin. For pussies, Bricks. They're going for two.
Yeah, they got big balls, Grim.
Yeah, bigger than yours.
Bam! Gutsy run for the conversion. Well, 2 years ago, this guy was a buried, rotting corpse at the end of the galaxy. And today, look at him. He's a dancing scoring machine.
What a story. What a wonderful story.
The home crowd isn't impressed with that showing, but their team has a chance to respond. he just got crushed. And it's first and 10. First and 10. And he snatches that one out of the air for a first down. See if they can get something going here. And it's first and 10. And that's how you run the football. A pickup of 7 on the play.
Ren, why is it that more mentally disturbed clowns don't play football? They'd be good.
You know, they're all in politics, apparently. And that play went nowhere fast. No gain. Third down and 3. The defense better look out. The offense called the Beast Boot dirty trick. Train. Nice pickup there for a first down. And it's first and 10. And that pass play is good for 8 yards. Second down and 2. Nailed him right on the numbers for a touchdown. The coach isn't liking that call. Oh, his head just exploded.
Let him in. Oh, shit.
Second down, and the offense says it's time to put the ref out of his misery. You know, Bricks, when the ref is faster than your football team, you got some serious issues. Second down and and they've had enough. The offense jumps on sides and attacks the ref. Second down and ain't gonna happen, partner. They pick up a nice chunk of yards on that pass play. Third down, the offense needs a miracle. And he's running like a moose. That, my friends, was an all-pro MFL hit. Now this one's gonna be tough. I hope he has a good enough leg for this one.
I saw him trying one on before the game. He looked okay, I think. Not
straight through the uprights. The best kind of kick is when it's right after a score.
Hey, speak for yourself. I'm usually the one who gets kicked after scoring.
First and 10. Second down, and we've got to pick up at least half of this. First down. first and 10. And he picks up maybe four on that play. Second down and 6. Nicely done for a first down. We've got a nail biter at the end of one. And it's first and 10. It's a nice gain of about 7 yards on that run. Second and 3. Oh, and that's how you play defense. Well, of course, he could have had an interception, returned it for a touchdown and changed the entire game, but I don't want to nitpick.
I do. The guy should have fucking caught it.
Third down and 3. The quarterback goes down. Zoom on his face. I want to see if he's crying. Most kickers should be able to make this one.
But will this kicker make it? Find out next time on MFL Game Day.
MFL is...
It's good. They're looking for a good return after giving up points. Let's see how they do.
Yeah, let's see if they always suck or if that was just a one-time thing.
First and 10. That's a 6-yard gain. And that'll be second down and 4.
Hot 1, hot 2.
Up a new set of downs. And it's first and 10. Perfect pass and a score. More points, so they're going for 2. No one was going to stop him. That's 2 points. The teams are lined up for the kickoff. They're going to be able to return this one. And it's first and 10. And the defense calls a Strawberry Fields dirty trick. Now this team quarterback has had enough. Come on, man. You got to catch that.
I don't catch anything, Rim. I'm retired.
Second down and 10. He's rumbling and stumbling. He could go all the way. first and 10. Oh, with the brain scrambler. Second down and 5. First and 10. He zings it in there for a 4-yard gain. Second down and 6. Oh, mama! He just knocked him into the next time zone.
Once he finds his head, he'll be okay.
First and 10. And he'll pick up the first down with a nice piece of running there. And it's first and 10. Good throw, good catch, but not quite good enough at 9 yards. That'll bring up second and 1. The QB might as well just... Oh, now the offense is getting kills.
Oh, this is a really violent game, guys. It's fantastic.
And the defense is on his heels. Oh, and they got him. That's a touchdown-saving tackle. At some point, they're going to need to put this ref out of his misery.
How about now, for instance? Here's a hint. Dirty tricks, attack the ref.
First down and 3. Defense has enough of this BS and jumps offside to lay waste to the referee. Way to go, guys. First and 2. Why go for one when you can go for two?
It's always been my philosophy, but Bricks can't even get one. Oh, you're talking about points.
And he finds his target for 2. Now, this reminds me of a lap dance I had by a skeleton once.
Oh, yeah, after the Mayhem ball at that club 16 under. Yeah, my wife could smell the bone marrow on me when I got home. Big trouble.
The home team is feeling confident as they get the kickoff into the air.
Scoring makes anyone confident.
It certainly does, Bricks. It certainly does. High five! And we're at the 2-minute warning.
I gotta pee!
And it's first and 10.
Murphy Brown!
What? What the hell was... The quarterback calls a timeout to stop the clock. They have 2 left. And it's first and 10. That's a 4-yard gain.
And the offense quickly calls their second timeout. That's how you do it.
Do what?
Second down and six. Pow! With the brain scrambler. And they are out of timeout. The clock just became their greatest enemy.
Really? The clock? The clock, Grim? I can smash a clock. That's not a great enemy.
We're not talking about waking up at the crack of noon. We're talking about the MFL, you moron.
And the defense gets another pick. Man, rough day.
Hey, Grim, what a minute.
Ouch! What is this, 80s wrestling?
First and 10. Oh, with the brutal hit. Under 2 minutes of timeout means the QB is playing beat the clock, and he better win. In a hurry-up offense, there is no huddle, so neither team can put their players on the bench. That ball was almost intercepted.
A man from prison just came out of the field.
It's the ref, idiot.
Oh.
Let's see what the penalty is. The offense goes into their two-minute drill.
What the hell is that?
It's the same thing as a hurry-up offense, you moron.
Second down, and a timeout is called by the quarterback. They have one left. And the offense goes into a hurry-up to pick up the pace of the game. And he stayed with the receiver and deflected the ball. The offense wants to speed things up, so it signals a hurry-up.
As Saban Prince's ex-girlfriend signaled when they...
And that's the kind of play you pay the secondary for.
You pay him for the pick six. For this, you just give him a pat on the head and tell him they don't suck.
Well, this kick is no guarantee.
Sure it is. If he misses, he's fired. Guaranteed.
And it's good!
You know, when in this league where murder and bribery are cheered,
Brex, I'm stopping it right there.
The best kind of kick is when it's right after a score.
Hey, speak for yourself. I'm usually the one who gets kicked after scoring.
Oh, with a punishing hit. And it's first and 10. And he was just starting to pick up some speed.
Hey, Grim, I know a guy if that's what you're after.
And the offense goes into their two-minute drill.
Which coincidentally happens to be Brick's match stupsing time.
That's why the girls...
And he was steering a pick six but dropped the interception.
And that's why he's on defense, schmuck.
And that's the end of the second quarter. Someone will need to pull together some bribe money as they head to their lockers. Stay with us for the Halftime Show, brought to you by our friends at Monsatan Industries. We make genetically altered frankenfood you'll have fun trying to identify. Well, the third quarter coming up. Bricks, this game has been a hot mess so far.
Yeah, kind of like the morning after eating hot chicken wings. It's a hot mess on the exit ramp, if you know what I mean.
Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if the defense can hold them. He's going to be able to run this one back.
I wonder if the kicker was setting up an easy kill.
Ah. Montezuma's revenge. That's a crap your pants and die tackle. That Montezuma was very vengeful, wasn't he, Briggs? Wonder what made him so mad.
Yeah, it was probably all the diarrhea.
Yeah, you're probably right.
Yeah, they probably ran out of toilet paper when he was in some all-inclusive resort, and he just got so mad and cursed anyone who came to Mexico forever to crap their pants. Sounds like he didn't really think it through because, you know, he should have made it specifically for the owners of the inclusives, but yeah, not the guests.
What the fuck are you talking about?
I don't really know right now. What day is it?
Second down and more than the QB would like. Third down, and the punter is warming up. Does the QB know which team he's on? Boom! And it's first and ten. Ever been hit like that before, Bricks?
Have you seen my beer?
And it's first and ten. Pow! With the brain scrambler! Second and three. Man, he shoveled his feet so well on that play. He should go to lost wages and deal cards. First down! And it's first and ten.
Don't you just love the sound of bones snapping and cracking? I mean, when they're not young.
And it's first and ten. A good run for 5 yards.
Hey, didn't move the changes, Gord, did it? How good can it be?
Second down and five. Oh, the defender almost picked off the ball on that one. Third down and five. Oh, and the quarterback threads the needle for a first down. When they use their beast boost injection. Close your eyes, Bricks. This is going to get ugly fast. And that's just a great run for a touchdown. Well, little chip shot here, extra point, but this guy could blow it. It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double-stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
The home team is feeling confident as they get the kickoff into the air.
Scoring makes anyone confident.
It certainly does, Bricks. It certainly does. High five. Oh, that's a vicious hit, and the crowd loves it.
He just turned that guy into 300 pounds of ground mutant meat.
And you can't hit a guy much harder than that. is unfortunate. That's a killer. It was right there, and then he dropped it.
Oh, scumbag is killing me in fantasy.
Second down and 10. And he runs it for 4 yards. Third down and 6. They've used a Strawberry Fields dirty trick. Those guys don't. And that's an incomplete pass. Looks like the defense got away with that one there.
They don't have to grab the receiver like that. He could get hurt.
Well, here comes the punting unit. You know, punters really do know how to party, Bricks.
Yeah?
Oh, yeah, I have pictures that, well, maybe actually shouldn't discuss this on here. Nice catch. He's not going down. Oh, nice hit. Like a 2-foot putt.
You miss 2-foot putts all the time, Grim.
The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
The best kind of kick is when it's right after a score.
Hey, speak for yourself. I'm usually the one who gets kicked after scoring.
First and 10. And that's the way you play a guy. Nice coverage. Second down and 10. Oh, great play by the defense. The receiver didn't stand a chance. Third down and 10. And that's a great 9-yard completion there.
Hey, it ain't great if you don't score or move the chains.
Well, they couldn't pick up a first down, so now they have to punt. That's a lovely shank for the punter today. He just put his team. He's got the ball now. Man, what a hit that was. And it's first and 10. And he just slipped away like a greased pig. To the races. Look at that little mutant run.
I don't think you can say that, Grim.
And it's first and 10. And this guy is making a name for himself tonight with a pickup of about 10 on that play.
Hey, he makes up a name for himself every night. That's how he stays ahead of the bounty hunters. He's won in 50 states.
Second down, the size of Brick's wiener.
Hey!
Sorry, partner. Caught for the first down. And it's first and 10. second down and a lot. Oh, a great catch, and he picks up a new set of downs. The third quarter mercifully ends. If this game is as painful to watch as we are to listen to, then please accept our apologies. This one is just about over.
I got the thing stuck in my ear again!
And he runs it in for the touchdown! Comes the extra point attempt. It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
Here comes the kicker.
Oh, I can't wait to hear this. What's the kicker, Grim?
This guy in the field.
Oh, I thought you were going to tell me a story like, here's the kicker. When I turned on the light, it wasn't a broad in my bed. It was a chick wearing a wig.
And the quarterback goes into a hurry-up offense and calls all the plays from the line of scrimmage from here on out. And another interception. Oh, man, he just laid the wood on that guy.
Yeah, if you're going to hit a guy that hard, you should at least kill him. Do him a favor.
Finish him.
And it's first and ten. Scores! You know, if you go frame by frame, you can see the cover of my son's death metal album.
Yeah, baby. Fill up the horns.
And they line up for the extra point. The kick is good!
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if the defense can hold them. Not a bad kick, but not a great one either.
Well, his nickname is Lukewarm.
And he's proud of that?
Yeah, that's why he named his clothing company Lukewarm Threads. Their marketing team hates it.
The offense changes the pace by going into a hurry-up. Receiver like glue.
You know, when I was little, my dad used to make me eat glue. My tongue would get stuck to the roof of my mouth, and I couldn't talk.
Your father was a very smart man, Bricks. Very smart.
And the quarterback signals for a hurry-up offense.
Hey, Ben, what's the hurry-up offense?
There's no huddle. The offense calls plays at the line of scrimmage and plays really fast.
Why would they do that?
How many times do we have to explain it to you? It saves the clock, dumbass.
Offense takes their first time out to discuss the strategy they've been practicing all week.
You think they have it down by now?
And the punter takes a break from knitting on the sidelines to come in and punt.
His knitting is superb, Grim. That cross-stitching, unbelievable.
He boomed that one. Let's see if they can get a return. And he's got a chance. Oh, with the punishing hit. First and ten.
One time, when I was playing, a guy hit me so hard, I went into a dark tunnel. Thought I saw my grandparents waving at me in the light. Turns out it was just the visitor's tunnel that he knocked me into, and it was the paramedics waving fingers in my face.
Thank you. Third down and, well, good luck. And like a monkey trying to... And Briggs, they just made up a whole lot of field in a hurry with that pass play.
And I just made up a new name for a sandwich.
Boring, but smart. Time to punt.
Whoa, whoa, you can't say that on the radio.
And he booted a high-arcing rainbow. And he snags the punt and looks for open field.
If that hit didn't cripple him, it certainly left skid marks.
When in a hurry-up offense, the offense needs to run out of bounds or take a timeout to stop the clock. And there's another pick. Man, this quarterback, oh, that was a big hit. Hey, Bricks, I'll bet you took a lot of shots like that over your career.
Let's see. About a quarter after three, Grim, but my watch is a bit slow.
And it's first and 10. This is your brain, and this is your brain on Berserker drugs. He's leaving a wake of destruction in his path. Oh, he just got crushed. Hey, yeah, Briggs, check the rule book. Is that a penalty?
Why would I have the rule book?
Oh, for fuck's sake.
I won't even get out of it.
First down and inches. Defense had enough with this rep and jumps off sides to kill him. First and 4. Lateral to his teammate, and he was running like he had a load in his pants. Picks up maybe 2.
We always ran with a load in our pants, Grim. It's a pretty good defensive tool. Except the zombies. They are freaks.
Oh, look at this guy break 10. Oh, and he just left an outline on the ground like he was trying to wipe out the dinosaur.
Must be opposite day, because he's the one who just got wiped out.
Third and 4. And he runs into the end zone for a touchdown. Now, there are some who would argue that we should just skip this step and make touchdowns worth 7.
What, and kick the kicker's job in half? They'd just be called sinners then.
It's good. Let's see if they can keep the momentum going and keep these fans happy and, or bloodthirsty, whichever. First and 10. Void rage. Because if you can't answer your question with violence. And that's perfect coverage. Nice deflection. Time to speed things up. The offense goes into a 2-minute drill. That's a 2-yard pass play, and that's not going to get it done. The offense needs to move the ball upfield. If there were any functioning brain cells before that hit, they're gone now. He's gonna have the IQ of a rutabaga after that hit. There's no reason to go. Burning a second timeout? What's going on in his head?
I'm guessing the monkey stopped bashing the cymbals or the hamster stopped running on the wheel.
If they don't pick it up here, they are giving a gift to the defense.
Let me
I tell you, getting shocked is no joke. I used to wear triple wool socks, slide around on a shag carpet for 8 hours, so I shocked my younger brother. I went to change the TV channel, he got blown across the room into the deer antlers.
The offense is running low on quarterbacks. They have only two left. They might consider running the ball more. Well, little chip shot here, extra point, but this guy could blow it. The kick is good!
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
The teams are lined up for the kickoff. Just catch it, run it back, and don't die. First and 10. That ball just sliced through the defense like butter.
I wish defenses were made.
That's a catch for a 10-yard gain. And the quarterback signals for a hurry-up offense. The offense calls plays at the line of scrimmage and plays really fast. And that's a run for no gain. Third down and a pussy. That's it. That's their last time out. It's them against the other team and the clock.
That doesn't seem fair. I'm going to throw a hammer on the field and even the odds.
In there and swats the ball away.
He can't catch, but he sure can swat.
And the offense goes into the hurry-up formation to try to conserve time. And that is one big first down. The QB needs to stop kissing his linemen and get back to the line of scrimmage. First and 10. Oh, and that's how you play defense. Of course, he could have had an interception, returned it for a touchdown, and changed the entire game, but I don't want to nitpick.
I do. The guy should have fucking caught it.
The offense wants to speed things up, so it signals a hurry up.
And same as Prince's ex-girlfriend signaled when they were doing it.
Yeah, she called it red.
And that's the kind of play you pay the secondary for.
You pay it for the pick six. For this, you just give them a pat on the head and tell them they don't suck.
And the offense goes into a hurry up to pick up the pace of the game. Give this guy a few catches and watch his confidence take off. He is deadly in the open field, Bricks. Oh, and he might have just saved a touchdown on that deflection. When in a hurry-up offense, the offense needs to run out of bounds or take a timeout to stop the clock. And the back gets in there and swats the ball away.
He can't catch, but he sure can swat.
The offense changes the pace by going into a hurry-up.
Does that mean the defense gets into a hurry-up, too?
Great play by the defense. It's not too often a quarterback gets rejected.
That's why that's the position I originally tried out for. I want to know what it's like for other people to accept you.
Now that went from a joke to making me feel feelings. Stop it. This isn't a place to feel feelings. This is football. And that's another turnover for the defense. Oh, and he breaks free and has nothing but open field in front of him. He's at the 40. He's at the 30. They're gaining on him.
Hey, come on. Move your ass. I got a a sawbuck riding on this asshole.
The other guys got caught in a mob. That's a win for the Rock and Rollers. It was total and complete and utter domination. Speaking of domination, look at the stilettos on that cheerleader.
I'd let her walk on my back.
I'll tell you what, I'll pay her to do a river dance on your back with golf shoes.
And let's go to the MVP to hear him let loose with some verbal diarrhea about just how special he is. Once again, the folks at Evil SN thank our viewing audience and the Mutant Football League for allowing us to telecast this sports presentation. This is Grim Blitzrow with Brickhead Mulligan and Bricks Jr. signing off.
Today's game was brought to you by the Hexxon Oil Corporation. We drill it, spill it, and kill it so you...